Thanks for joining me, and in today's video, we're going to take a look at five reasons why you should not have a joint bank account with your spouse or significant other. Stay tuned. Now, I do have another video that does talk about some benefits when it comes to having a joint account, because there are some pros and cons. There's some benefits to having a joint account, but there's also some issues with having combined bank accounts. So in this video, we're going to cover the issues and problems that relate to it. So we're going to start with kind of number one, and that is less control. One of the parties involved could drain the account without the other person knowing. Now, this could be prevented by having, both to sign a joint bank account. You know, you put on signatures, but if you look at some of these law-related things, here's kind of an article. My ex emptied our joint bank account during divorce. So, you know, what's happening is like you're going through divorce, you got this joint bank account, and somebody just comes in and boom, sweeps under the rug and gets a bunch of the money. Now, you don't have to be too stressed about these kinds of things, because what happens when one spouse empties a bank account prior to divorce, you know, what's going to happen is everything that was kind of in that account, it's considered money that belongs to both parties. So this is kind of what it's talking about here in this note, in this article. Again, nothing's really certain till the law or the court decides it. But what may happen is that, let's say you put in 80% of the money, and your spouse put in 20% of the money, well, they just took out a bunch of your money. You know, so you have to be very careful and mindful that, hey, there's a lot more that you've contributed than they contributed. And now this actually gets split into that 50-50 relationship or you know, split in terms of the finances. So you have to be mindful that this is what could happen. Anyways, so be careful in that case that there's a lot less control when you have a joint bank account. Okay, let's take a look at another reason here, and that is it complicates separation. Now, I know not everybody thinks about, hey, when they get married or combining a joint bank account that, hey, what if I get separated or what if I don't last with this person? You know, it's kind of like cynical, maybe a little negative, but it does happen. There's a lot of divorces, you know, more than 50% of the people get divorced. So when you think about this, divorce rates are sky high. That, yeah, you have to think about these things, that it complicates the separation process. Having one account can complicate things in case of that breakup. And really, it can be a huge issue. I'm part of a lot of different groups on Facebook just to be able to see and what's going on, what's happening in the space, or just what people are talking about. So this is one for personal advice for women. You can see here's a comment. I need help. What do you do when your spouse is absolutely terrible about money, lies, hides behind your back, between family members, and makes you feel like the bad guy when it comes to talking about finances? So yeah, things can evolve and get kind of nasty pretty quickly. So you got to be mindful that even though you're with somebody, you might not see those darker sides or behind the picture of what's going on with their personal finances till you get deeper in the relationship. And that's when things can, you know, hit the fan. So anyways, so let's go on to number three here, and that is inequity. It's not inequality, but kind of inequity. If one partner contributes more into the account than the other, it could result in arguments. So, you know, it's kind of like, hey, I put in $50,000 this year, you only put in $10,000 this year. And that could, you know, create some jealousy, create some doubt for the other person if they're doing their fair share. For a man, it could make them not feel as well. So this could lead to other problems. So good communication is key, and making sure that things are set up accordingly or properly in your personal situation. Now, here is some Pew Research Center that still talks about it. So even if you got a man and a woman married, that kind of thing, even then, we still have a gender pay gap. So women earn, you know, 84 cents on the dollar compared to men. So it's 84% of what men earn. And basically, this can lead to a little bit more of, hey, arguments, issues, and that kind of thing. So be careful and mindful of what's going on in your relationship. And sometimes maybe having separate bank accounts is nice. And then somebody else goes in and kind of gives an allowance or a bonus to be able to even things out. Again, it's just a little bit different for every situation. So anyways, let's look at reason number four on why you should not have a joint bank account. And that is because there's less privacy. And you might think, well, why do I need privacy when I have a spouse or a committed partner? Well, joint accounts make it harder to have financial privacy, because if you want to surprise your partner with a gift, this can become an issue. Like, let's say you're throwing a surprise birthday party. Well, now you're starting to spend things, and then the other person's kind of looking at you and saying, oh, what is this for? What is that for? What is this for? And that starts to become an issue. So when you have something like a birthday party, it can become a problem. And the other thing I will tell you is, let's say you're looking to buy an engagement ring. You know, and you got this bank account there, and maybe you went in, you did a deposit, and now you the bill is coming in, or that kind of stuff. So it's really important that you just understand that there's going to be a little less privacy, even if it's for things that maybe are good intentioned. You could run into some issues by not having that separate bank account. So anyway, let's look at number five here, and that is the loss of independence. So this is basically when you become more dependent on the other person, not independent, but dependent. It's kind of like when you think about it when you're a kid, right? You're 10 years old, you got mommy and daddy. Mommy and daddy are taking care of everything. That's when you're the dependent. But when you have now a joint bank account, and let's say only a joint bank account, then in that case, sharing one account can translate into losing independence while spending money and feeling restricted or being kind of watched. So when you really look at it, it's just the statue of not having enough income to pay one's living expenses. You feel like you're depending on somebody else to kind of live the life that you want to live on a personal financial level. Now, what some people do, in case you're wondering, is you could have your separate bank accounts, but then you also have a joint bank account for joint bills, and everybody contributes a certain portion, whether that's on a percentage basis, whether that's on a dollar figure basis, whether that's on a percentage of the income or percentage of the bill expenses. That's kind of up to you to figure out of what makes sense based on your income levels, how people are working, your working, your job, your situation. But that's another approach, having a hybrid situation in your personal life where, hey, I've got my account, you've got your account, and we have one account that's also together for common household family bills. And that just makes things a lot easier. You don't have to worry about one thing or another. I understand some people say, no, let's just group our money. But on the other hand, in some cases, this could be maybe a little bit more problematic for other relationships. So you have to figure out what makes sense and works for you. Anyways, that's why I wanted to share with you some of these kind of issues and why you should not have a bank account, kind of a joint bank account with your spouse. So you could see kind of some of the issues that go along with it. But it's to say that the bigger problem is more just having all your money pooled into that one single source. Instead, the better approach might be to have a hybrid account where you have part of your money split up and you both have separate accounts, but then also one account may be joint. Yes, it may be a little bit more of problematic, but it's a good compromise for couples that somebody might want to say have separate accounts and somebody might want to have a joint account. So how do you make it work? You could do that hybrid approach where you have one joint account and then you also have separate accounts as well. So anyways, thanks for joining me. Hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you check out our website at MyLittleNestEgg.com. At least this is what the team came up with. This is some of the great research, and we've got some other great articles here to come. So I'll see you there in the next episode.